Hey guys, it's Kevin again, and with the fall season rapidly approaching, it is time for me to do my preview of all of the shows coming out this fall. Specifically, we're only going to focus on September and October. If you guys saw my video last year, I did that, and it worked a lot better. And the reason I do that, if you guys are wondering, it's because most times if I talk about something that comes out in November, there are like all these other dates that are announced way after I do the video, and I'm like, shit, I really wish I could have talked about that. And because of, you know, me not being able to, you know the schedule, that's why I don't talk about November and December, because most likely there are going to be other things that premiere in those months that we're going to find out about in like a month or so, you know, via Netflix. So that's what Netflix has been doing a lot recently. And, you know, I'll miss it, and it'll be a really great show. And, you know, it happens every year. So that's why I'm not doing that. Also, I'm going to tell you guys this right now. I say this every single year. Half of these shows I'm going to talk to you guys about, I'm probably not going to watch, because that's just the nature of the beast. We are living in an era where there is way too much TV consumption going on. There really is. I understand that there are, you know, different kinds of networks and things like that that have, you know, the different, like Netflix is trying to become a legit network. I totally understand that. But there's just too much. I mean, if you guys want me to watch all these shows, you have to understand, certain shows I don't watch because I don't have time to fit it in. Not because I'm not interested, but because I don't have time to fit it in. I didn't finish Doctor Who season, for example, because I did not have time to fit it in. Am I going to finish it? Yes, but I did not have time to fit in. A lot of the Netflix shows, like Orange New Black, I did not have time to fit that in. It's just, there's too much TV going on. And this season, the good thing is that there are a lot of the new shows don't really look all that great. The downside is that a lot of the new shows don't really look all that great. But the upside, as I said, is that there's not as much TV for me to review, so hopefully I will be able to fit as much in there. And I'll try to talk about, you know, when I get to my schedule at the end of all this, I'll try to review as much of those shows as possible. But if I don't, if it's a show that I fell off because I didn't like it, I'll tell you guys that straight up. I'll be straight up, you guys say I didn't like it. If it's something where I just fell off, well, that's just kind of what's going to happen. So if that happens, I apologize. But either way, guys, let's just get into it, starting off with the first premiere date. So before I get into September, there is actually one premiere date I do want to bring your attention to, and that is on August 19th. This already has premiered. That is the final season of Halt and Catch Fire, which, I mean, I've talked about this show enough, but if you want to talk about underrated show, this is easily one of the shows on TV right now that just does not get enough coverage. I mean, it's an incredible show. It's a genius show about, the influence of technology and, you know, the butting heads between those two things. But it's also a fantastic character drama about passions and focusing on one dream and, you know, basically, you know, fixing your entire life around that. And that's what a big part of the show has been. And this final season so far, I've only seen the first two episodes, has been absolutely exceptional. I think they're doing such a great job with it. They're skipping time a lot, but I think it's kind of necessary to the show, but it still is fantastic. You know, like I said, it does have a lot of computerism talk, so if you're not into that, it's not the show for you. But it also is a very good character drama, and it really does get into how flawed these characters really are. And it's gone from a show that was very much just like trying to be this, you know, peak TV sort of show, and it's actually evolved into something really incredible. And I highly recommend you guys check it out if you haven't. It's already premiered if you guys want to check it out. Halt and Catch Fire season 4. It's a very easy binge. It's just 3 seasons of 10 episodes. I was able to do 2 seasons last year, and I got it done very quickly. But if you guys are interested in Halt and Catch Fire, like I said, it does return. It already returned on the 19th. There's not gonna be another new episode till, not this week, but the following week, because this week is Labor Day, so there's not gonna be, you know, it's not premiering this week, it's premiering the following week. But if you guys want to check that out, just wanted to throw that out there, and, yeah. Now, guys, let's get into the actual premiere dates, the things that have not premiered yet, and the first one we're gonna talk about, I am bringing your attention to now. I don't know when this video is going to go up. I'm going to say that right now. At the timing of this video, it is currently Thursday the 31st, and this show is not premiered yet. But if I do upload this on Friday, then this premiered today, and that is the third season of Narcos, which you guys know I did watch the first season. Didn't absolutely love it. I thought it was a really good show, but I didn't think it was anything amazing. But I really love Wagner Mora. He was incredible in this role as Escobar, and I meant to finish season two, but again, that's just one of those shows I fell off of. I'm currently binging it though, because I do want to finish season two so I can get into season three, even though I don't have to do that because season three, they're essentially revamping the show. Pedro Pascal is actually gonna be the main character, which I'm happy about because I never really liked Boyd Holbrook that much. He's not a bad actor. I don't know. I couldn't really get into his character. I wasn't the hugest fan of him. But where they're going is really interesting. They're gonna focus on the Cali Cartel. And also, if you guys do like Halt and Catch Fire, Carrie Bishop from that show is actually gonna be a main character on this season. So I'm looking forward to seeing really what they do here. And I do really like Narcos as a whole. It's just never really been a show that's like hooked me in as much as some of the other ones have been. But I still really do love what I've seen of it. I do think it is a very well put together show. And I do think that if these first two seasons haven't hooked me in, I'm hoping season three really does. Again, these have not been bad seasons to me. They've been perfectly great seasons. I definitely have liked what we've gotten from them. I just feel they could have been a lot better, and I'm looking forward to seeing really what they can do in season three. So if you guys are looking forward to Narcos season three, it does premiere September 1st, and definitely look forward to that if you are a fan. So next up, we have on Wednesday, September 6th, the fourth season of You're the Worst comes out on FXX, which I'm definitely looking forward to this season. They're taking things in a darker direction. Obviously, we know that Jimmy left Gretchen. Basically, he said that he proposed and then he just left her there. And it seems like things are gonna get really dark really fast. And I did like last season. Last season was, I think, my least favorite season of the show. It was still a great season, but it was my least favorite season. So I am hoping the show gets a little bit back on track here because I do think they got away from some of the really great character stuff in season two. So I'm hoping they get back to in season four. We'll have to see. It's a 1 hour premiere. I'm definitely gonna be watching it. You guys know how much I love the show. I still do love the show. I just feel like season three wasn't as strong as the previous two were. But September 6th, at 10 o'clock on FXX, I will definitely be watching that one. And then September 8th is definitely a big day. We have two really big things coming out. First of all, we have the second season of One Mississippi on Amazon, which a lot of people didn't like. I personally really enjoyed it, but I'm now realizing that a lot of people really didn't like the show. I mean, I'd say check it out. I definitely really did enjoy it, but that is coming back. And this fourth season of BoJack Horseman, we've all been awaiting for it. We thought it was going to come out in the summer, but no, it's coming out on September 8th, which I'm perfectly fine with. I'm going to binge this very quickly, specifically because I'm in college now and I don't have class on Friday. So I'm able to binge the entire fourth season on Friday. I'm probably just going to take that whole day and binge that season, and I will get that done very fast. And yeah, so I'm definitely looking forward to both of these. I really do love both these shows. They're both rapidly different, but they're also similar in that they both are comedies with a lot of dramatic elements. I'd argue that BoJack Horseman is more of a drama than a comedy, even though it does have a lot of comedy in there. I'd say it definitely is more of a dramedy, and One Mississippi is as well. But both these shows, I highly recommend if you guys haven't checked them out. They both premiere on September 8th, if you're interested. So definitely check those out. And then on September 9th, we have a show on Sci-Fi called Con Man. This was a show on YouTube. I don't know too much. Actually, I know it was online, but I can't think of what it was. I think it was either on YouTube or Hulu or one of those sort of things, maybe even Yahoo possibly. But basically, they're gonna put the whole first season on Sci-Fi. I don't know if I'm gonna be watching this. There's just a lot on, and I don't know if I'm really gonna have time to fit Con Man in there. But if you guys are interested, they are gonna basically show the entire season on September 9th at 10 o'clock, and then the second season will also air at a later date. So definitely be on the lookout for that. But now we get to September 10th, which is, okay, here's where we get to the crazy stuff, because it goes from very sporadic to very crazy very fast, and September 10th is really the first day of that. There is a lot of stuff premiering on this day, but the first one we have to talk about is a new show on Fox at 8 o'clock called The Orville.
I just want to say I am thrilled to be your new captain. I want this to be an efficient ship, but also one that you're glad to be serving on. Lieutenant Commander Bordas, your entire species is male, isn't it?
That is correct, sir.
Probably not a lot of arguments about leaving the toilet seat up and that kind of thing, right?
Mocklins urinate only once per year.
Really? I'm up two, three times a night.
That is unfortunate.
It is.
The Time to meet the locals.
Hi, I'm Captain Ed Mercer. Holy crap! We don't mean your family any harm.
Well, we did just shoot his dad.
Aside from shooting your dad, we don't mean your family any harm.
Captain, there's a message coming in from Admiral Halsey. It says that an executive officer has become available.
No.
No, 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 no. Crap. Sorry, man. You okay?
Yeah, it's all good, man. You okay?
Yeah, all good. Sorry.
All right, no worries.
So, the Orville guys. For this show, like I said, there aren't a lot of new shows coming out that I'm really looking forward to. This, on the other hand, is in fact one of them. I think this show looks like it's a lot of fun. And what I really do love is that it is actually something really different from Seth MacFarlane. You know, we're used to him doing these very raunchy animated comedies, you know, with tons of like body humor and tons of, you know, pop culture references. And that doesn't seem like that's what the show is. This is, yes, it is a parody of Star Trek, but it also seems like it is genuinely its own thing. And I'm very happy about that. Seth MacFarlane actually is acting in here. Also got Adrian Palicki, Chad Holman, just a really good cast overall. Don't know too much about the plot, but I know Jon Favreau is also directing the pilot, and again, I've said so many times, when Jon Favreau is involved, his passion usually really does inflict on what he's doing, so I think that definitely is going to help the show out, but I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how the show really does turn out. Haven't heard too much about it, but I did hear it's very different than what the trailers do entail, so I guess take it or leave it. The only annoying thing about this, guys, is it's one of those things where it's going to premiere on a Sunday, and then it's going to, you know, just like randomly on a Sunday. I think it's because it's after football or whatever, but it's normally going to be on Thursdays at 9 o'clock starting on September 21st. I know it's really confusing. I don't know why shows do this sometimes, but they are going to be on Sunday nights on the 10th and the 17th, and they're going to move over to Thursdays at 9 on September 21st. I don't know why Fox does this, but they did this with Son of Zorn. I don't know if they wanted the show to get canceled, but it seems like that's what they do a lot. But if you guys are interested, The Orville does premiere on Fox at 8 o'clock on September 10th, and yeah, definitely looking forward to seeing how that turns out. But also coming out of the day is the third season of Outlander, which I obviously am very much looking forward to. I don't really know how the season's going to be, given the way that season 2 really did leave off. It looks like it's going to be a bit of a different season, and especially with the time jumps, it does seem like they're going to catch us up on a lot of what's happened. And I did hear that a lot of my worries about the trailer, I shouldn't be too worried about. The book is actually a lot less convoluted than the trailer does present itself to be, so I'm looking forward to seeing how the season really is. You guys know how much I love Outlander, and it's weird it's going to be on Sundays, but also at 8 o'clock is a weird time for the show, but I'm definitely looking forward to it. You know, Outlander is a show that I absolutely love, and always going to make room for that. But also, on 9 o'clock, we have the mid-season premiere of Fear the Walking Dead, which I actually have surprisingly loved this season. I actually really did love what we've gotten so far, and I really do hope that quality continues into the second half of the season. Also, we have the premiere of Top of the Lake China Girl, which is the sequel to Top of the Lake. I have not seen the original Top of the Lake, but I've heard many things about it. If I have the time, I will binge the first Top of the Lake, and then I will watch China Girl. But if I don't review it, then it's just that simple. I'm not going to watch it again. I hate having to do that. I hate having to pick and choose shows, but, you know, if I could watch everything, I would. It's just not humanly possible. There's just simply too much on. However, what I will definitely be watching is the new show on HBO at 9 o'clock called The Deuce.
Scary world out here, babe. Thoroughbred like you, we would own this damn street.
I'm gonna keep what I earn. I don't need you. I don't need anybody else to hold my money for me.
Frankie, you stole Tommy everything, including today's fig.
Frankie, he owes everybody in New York City. My name's Vincent.
My twin brother. We don't have the cash to cover his debt. We gotta get it and deliver.
No late payments. Understood.
Everyone against the van.
If I was you, gentlemen, I would take any offer that moved your ladies off the pavement.
Been running women off the streets for a while now. The parlors are all paying us.
But this is not news.
We've called out city corruption before.
There's been a change.
So, The Deuce. I've covered this show before, and I have talked a lot about it. I'm really looking forward to this show, mainly because, for two things. One, it really is redeeming HBO for the Vinyl debacle, because let's face it, Vinyl, I didn't personally think it was a terrible show, but it was so off from what HBO usually did. It really did not feel like an HBO show. It felt like something that would be better on Showtime. It really did. It felt like something that I think Showtime would have done a lot better on, because Showtime usually has those kind of shows, and it didn't have the rich storytelling that HBO usually has. It just didn't really work. The Deuce, however, does seem the way, and I'll tell you why. This is actually from David Simon. If you don't know who that is, he's done both The Wire and Tremé, two of HBO's most successful shows, and he's also co-creating it with George Pelicanos, and he's the guy behind, I believe, The Sopranos, I think he did, and these guys really know what they're doing, and I really do trust these guys. The pilot's also directed by the woman that did the Breaking Bad, Michelle McLaren. She actually did direct a couple episodes of Breaking Bad, so I have a lot of comments in the show. I really do hope this is something great. Basically, it's about like the porn industry during the late 70s and the 1980s, but also you got James Franco, and they're kind of going the Fargo route where he's playing two different characters, which I think is definitely very interesting. You can actually watch the first episode right now. I don't know if I'm going to get it out to you early. I might try to, but if I don't get out to you early, I definitely will be watching on September 10th. I think this definitely looks like probably one of the most promising shows out there. I'm definitely looking forward to this show. In fact, probably out of all the new shows, this is the one I'm looking forward to the most. I think this definitely looks like a really great show. HBO has been on such a hot streak lately, and I hate to see them lose that. I think, again, I've said it ever since the night of, they've just been so consistent, and I really hope that quality continues here, because they've just been having hit after hit, and I really hope that the hits don't stop here, because they have been doing amazing stuff so far. Like I said, all that stuff does come out on September 10th. You know, The Deuce, The Orville, Fear the Walking Dead, Outlander, Top of the Lake, China Girl, all of those are on September 10th. It's a pretty big day. I mean, it's early in the month, but already we got a lot of stuff premiering, and it really doesn't stop there. It just kind of gets crazier, like I said, as it goes on, as the fall season usually does. On September 12th, we have the final season of The Mindy Project. I never really got into the show. I watched, like, the first season, but I was just kind of in and out of it, and it's way too far into, I think it's, like, season 6 or 7 now for me to even try to binge it. Maybe at some point, maybe if I have nothing to do, maybe I will, but I just don't really see that happening. But The Mindy Project, if you guys are interested, last season does premiere on September 12th, if you guys are looking forward to that. Also on September 13th, we have the premiere of the new season of South Park, which I definitely will be watching. I haven't watched a lot of South Park, but of what I've seen, I absolutely love it, and I've heard they've just been getting better and better as the seasons have gone on, especially because they've just covered, like, one topic, and it's been, like, a serialized show, so I definitely do want to watch it. I've heard really great things about it. And then Broad City as well, heard great things about this one. Probably gonna check out both of those at 10:30, September 13th, definitely look forward to that. September 14th, however, I want to turn your guys' attention to a show that I really feel did not get enough love last season, and that's Better Things, which even went under my radar. You know, you watch the first episode and you're like, do I really need to continue? Absolutely. Stick with it. It is definitely a show that, you know, you'll watch the first episode and maybe you'll feel it's just better as a standalone, which I personally did. I said this is just a good 20-minute short film and that's it. But stick with it, and it actually gets better and better, and quickly, this will become one of your favorite, you know, shows that you're watching currently. I mean, it is one of the fastest binges for me. I got season one done so quickly. I loved everything about the first season. It perfectly, you know, focused on the idea of motherhood and sort of how Pamela Adlon's character's, you know, life, how Sam's life, you know, as an actress, how that actually does corrupt her motherhood, and how that kind of has to take a back seat at points. I think they very well showed that. But it also very well showed the idea of, you know, just, you know, being a great mother and what that really means, and, you know, helping out your daughters and things like that. Just all these characters I really did fall in love with very quickly. Better Things is easily one of my favorite shows on TV right now, and I'm definitely looking forward to seeing it come back. 10 o'clock FX, definitely will be watching it, and yeah, definitely look forward to that one. But then on Friday, September 15th, we have another new show premiering on Netflix, which, again, Netflix, just, they don't listen to me. They do not stop with their new shows. But that is a show that I actually am really looking forward to, called American Vandal.
It's just not the way I thought things were going to go. I was going to graduate high school, get my degree in, like, engineering. I know I didn't do it.
It is a shocking scene for Hanover High teachers today. The vandal spray painted obscene images on 27 cars.
Oh my God.
I'll never understand what's so amusing about penises.
Everyone thinks I did it. Everyone.
Dylan definitely did it.
Of course he did it.
He's like a known dick drawer.
Another day, another dick.
The evidence, it's overwhelming.
I spoke to expel Dylan Maxwell for vandalizing the vehicles.
So this show, you know, look, I've talked about before, Netflix, I think, has really been overdoing it in terms of series, though. This is genius, honestly. This whole concept, I am so behind, because what is one of the hottest sort of topics right now when it comes to TV? That would be the true crime genre. It is such a, you know, I don't know what really happened, but ever since People vs. OJ, it seems like every single network wants to do their own People vs. OJ. They're trying to replicate that and, you know, not necessarily replicate, like they're doing their own thing, but they're doing something very similar to what People vs. OJ did. This show is actually satirizing that, because it's about, you know, this kid who he drew like a dick photo on like 27 faculty cars, and it's all about should this kid be acquitted for this, and it just looks like a lot of fun. You can tell they're not taking the show too seriously. You can tell that they're just having a lot of fun here, and I really do love this concept. I think, again, it's such a hot topic right now. You know, it's such a big genre. You're seeing so many different shows about it. One of them I'm really looking forward to this, you know, fall season, actually, one of the most promising new shows out there. But American Vandal, I'm definitely looking forward to this. I think this honestly sounds like a really genius idea, and I really do hope the show is executed as well as the concept really does sound, because if it really is, I think this could easily be one of the funniest things that Netflix has put out in a while. Definitely looking forward to seeing how American Vandal is turning out. But if you guys are interested, it does premiere Friday, September 15th. Definitely looking forward to checking that one out. But then on September 17th, we have the second season of Vice Principals, and also the last season. They already said it's only going to be two seasons, and I'm perfectly fine with that. I have not watched the first season of the show. Again, if I have time, I will binge it, but if not, I'm just not going to watch it because, you know, why bother? It's the last season, you know. Maybe at some point I will, but most likely I will not be watching it. What I will absolutely be watching, though, is the Emmy Awards. You guys know every single year I do some sort of live stream dedicated to the Emmys. I did it last year, and, you know, I did it the year before, and I'm going to do it this year. I'm really happy with the turnout overall. Don't know why The Leftovers got completely snubbed. That is a completely different conversation, but you guys can definitely look forward to me watching the Emmys on CBS this year. They change the network every single year, but Stephen Colbert is hosting this year. I've always really liked Stephen Colbert, so I'm hoping he does a really good job. September 17th, definitely looking forward to that, and definitely do want to check that one out. September 18th, we do have the return Dancing with the Stars. I mean, I know my mom really likes that. I don't really care that much about it, but if you guys are interested, then have at it. We also have on September 19th, the return of Tosh.0. Again, not something I watch, but I know a lot of people definitely really do like that. But then September 20th, we have the return of two shows, one of them being The Good Place, which is another show that I really tried, guys. I tried to binge the show. I kept trying to catch up on it, but I just fell behind. I don't know what happened, but I really wanted to catch up on the show, and the time that I could, it was just simply too late. You know, it was way too far into its season, and it ended, and I'm just like, I'm not gonna have time to do it. I am going to binge the first season before second season, because The Good Place became one of NBC's best shows in a while. I really do love the show. Kristen Bell is just so great in this role, and her and the other dude, I can't think of his name right now, but he plays, I can't even think of his name, but he plays, you know, the black friend. I can't think of his name right now. I'm sorry. I'm blanking on his name, but let me check real quick, actually. Chidi, yeah, William Jackson Harp's character. I don't know why I forgot his name there. I was blanking on it, but his character, their dynamic, I absolutely love. I think they work so well together. Ted Danson's great. I mean, just the whole cast is really great here. It's easily one of my favorite things, like I said, NBC's put out in a while. And definitely looking forward to seeing how the second season is. And then also you got the return of Channel Zero, which I actually heard really good things about, surprisingly. Which this season is going to be focused on the No End House story. Don't know too much about that. I know this show is based on a bunch of creepypastas, which personally I've always been into creepypastas. So I definitely will check. I might check this out. We'll have to see, but definitely looking forward to seeing how that one turns out. And then September 21st, we do have the return of Gotham, a show that I could care less about, but I know a lot of people, especially the last season, really did get into it. So if you're interested in Gotham, there you go. But also, like I said, this will be the day that the Orville moves to its regular time slot. Again, I don't know why Fox always does this. They seem to do this every single year, and I would really be worried, honestly, if I were you guys. If you guys really want the Orville to do well, watch it, because this is automatically a death sentence, because usually when Fox does this, the show ends up doing horribly because people don't realize the show's actually moved to a different time slot. And if Fox doesn't heavily promote this, this could really end up hurting the Orville. So if you guys really want the Orville to do well, watch it and keep an update because it is in fact moving to September 21st. I don't know why, it just is. But on September 22nd, we do have the first half of the season of Fuller House. Yeah, Netflix is doing this thing now where all of their laugh track type comedies, they're going to split them into two halves of the season. I don't exactly know why, but I will be reviewing the first half of season 3, and then when season 3 is over, me and 22 Tiger Dude will come together and we will review season 3 together, just like we did with season 2. I really enjoyed that, and he said he wants to wait till the season's over, so we're probably just gonna do that. But like I said, I personally will be reviewing the first half of the season, so look forward to that. Definitely looking forward to Fuller House. No, it's not the greatest Ren show in the world, but I get a kick out of it. You know, I definitely have a great time, so I'm looking forward to it overall. And then you also have the return of Transparent, which, again, it's a show that every year I say, I'm going to binge it. I'm going to be honest with you guys, I really couldn't get into it. I could not get into Transparent for the life of me. I didn't really find the characters all that compelling. I really was not that into the story. It's just not really something I could see myself sticking with. It's one of those shows where I feel like I'd start watching it and then I'd drop it after like season 2. So that's why I have not really taken the time. I just really have not had that much motivation to watch Transparent. There are just many other things I'd rather watch. Is it a bad show? No. I think it definitely has a target audience. I'm just not someone that really does like it all that much. I mean, yes, there are definitely amazing performances on there, but I just personally am not really a huge fan. But if you are looking forward to Transparent, it does come out September 22nd, the same day as Fuller House, so definitely look forward to that. And then September 24th, we have probably one of the biggest premieres out of all the new shows, and that is CBS's newest Star Trek iteration, that being Star Trek Discovery.
The Klingon Empire has been in disarray for generations.
We've encountered them.
We have been waiting for someone worthy of our attention.
Captain, incoming!
Right, so Star Trek Discovery, I'm gonna tell you guys up front right now, I am not the biggest Star Trek fan. Really, all my knowledge of Star Trek are the new movies. That's really all I've seen. So if you want, like, a better opinion of Star Trek, you've come to the wrong place. Because I don't know too much about the series. All I know are the J.J. Abrams movies, which I think all those are fantastic. I know a lot of Star Trek fans are not a huge fan of them. Personally, I just look at them as movies. I think they're all really well done. This show, I don't know what it is. I really like the cast, you know, Sinequa Michael Green, Rainn Wilson, I think Jason Isaacs is in there, you know, Mary Wiseman, just really great cast overall. It's just really not grabbing me, and I don't know what exactly it is, if it's just the way the show is being advertised or the way it's done, but just something about it, it's not really hooking me in all that much. I don't really think it looks all that great, honestly. Of course, I'm going to check it out because it's Star Trek. Obviously, I'm going to check it out. And I think it is a wise move for CBS to put this on their network first because, if you guys don't know, this is going to be a CBS All Access series. But what CBS is doing, they're going to premiere the first episode. They're going to do like what they do with The Good Fight where they put the first episode on CBS and then like, if you want to continue, you have to pay the $5, which I say absolutely do it. It's $6 a month. It's really not that big of a deal. At this point, I'm not even paying for feeds. I'm paying just for Star Trek because I do want to watch it. It's just the promos have not really been grabbing me. I think the show itself is going to be really good. The visuals look fantastic. I just don't really know how this is really going to be. I think it's a cool idea that you have, like, a female captain or whatever. I think that's something they really haven't done before. But we'll have to see how the show really does turn out. I'm definitely interested in seeing, you know, how this one really is. But if you are interested in Star Trek Discovery, it does premiere on September 24th at 8:30 on CBS. But remember, it's only going to be on CBS for 1 week. All the other episodes are going to be on CBS All Access. You have to pay the $6, and that's just kind of how it's going to go. Definitely interested in seeing how this one really does turn out. Also premiere on September 24th are a bunch of things that I personally do not care about. My favorite show in the world, Kim and the Kardashians, are having their 10th year anniversary special. Can't wait to not watch that and see tons of people tweet about and me not give a shit. I have expressed my hatred for that show so many times before. It's just, in my opinion, the definition of just trash TV. It really is. I am not a fan of that show whatsoever. Then we have a documentary on Fox, which does sound interesting. It's called Who Shot Biggie and Tupac? But the thing that makes me upset is that it's on Fox. If it was on something like HBO or Showtime, I think it'd be a lot better. Maybe I'll check it out. I really am into this whole, you know, I like stuff like this. You know, I didn't watch All Eyes on Me, but I am interested in the story of these two. So we'll have to see the way that one does turn out. But now we get to Monday, September 25th. And this is when things turn into a madhouse. Because as I said, this is how September, just as the more it progresses, the more shows you add, and the more nerve-wracking it does get. But again, the good thing is, most of these shows don't really look all that great. They really don't. So we're going to start off pretty simple here. First of all, on CBS, at 8 o'clock, we have, regular Big Bang Theory. I don't know why the show hasn't ended yet. It just keeps going on and on and on, and it seems like it has no end in sight, and it's really starting to bother me, I have to say. I once was a fan of the Big Bang Theory, but come on, enough is enough already. I don't really think many people... I mean, there are people that watch the show, obviously, but I feel like anyone that loved the Big Bang Theory, they're just not really watching anymore because they found other things to watch. And personally, for me, I'm just not really the hugest fan of it. I know it has its fans out there. 22 Tiger, dude, if you're out there, I know you do watch it. But personally, I'm just not the huge... I liked it, but I just feel like it's gone on way too long. However, I am interested in the show after it, and that being Young Sheldon.
Why would you entertain evil thoughts?
I don't think this part applies to me.
Shh.
I'm only 9 years old. Most evil doesn't start till puberty.
How about we lose the bow tie?
Why?
Look around, honey. No one else is wearing one.
Perhaps I'll start a fad.
Why can't we watch DuckTales?
Because we don't learn anything.
It's TV. We aren't supposed to learn.
Oh, Young Sheldon. Right off the bat, at first glance, you know, is this a show we need? Absolutely not. I think we have enough stuff with the Big Bang Theory going on. In fact, I was completely against the show until I saw the trailer. And the trailer here is really, really great. And I really did like what we actually did get in this trailer. Not only does this look like a show that is way different from Big Bang Theory. It looks a lot more heartwarming. It looks like it's actually going to tell a really good story. But it's also single camera. And laugh tracks, I don't dislike laugh tracks, but they don't really do a ton for me. They take me out of the show very easily. And the fact that this is a single camera comedy in general tells me this is going to be a rapidly different show from The Big Bang Theory. And I'm definitely very happy about that. You do have Jim Parsons narrating, but actually the kid from Big Little Lies who played Ziggy, Ian Armitage, he's actually going to be the one that plays Sheldon Cooper, and he looks like he embodies that character very well. I don't know, there's a big part of the show that kind of reminds me of The Wonder Years a little bit, if you guys know that show. That's a show my parents are a big fan of. I personally really do like it as well, but Young Sheldon, if you guys are interested in it, it does premiere on 8:30 at 8:30 on CBS. I am looking forward to seeing how this one does turn out. Also on CBS, though, at 9 o'clock, we have The Return of Kevin Can Wait, which this is really interesting because we have Kevin Can Wait coming back, but they're killing off the mother. Like, Erin Hayes is literally being killed off. She was dropped from the cast, for unforeseen circumstances that I'm not going to get into here. But yeah, she's dropped from the cast, and then they're bringing on Leah Remini. So yes, Kevin James and Leah Remini are getting back together. Why they're not just doing a King of Queens, reboot, I don't know. I don't know why they're not just doing a revival of that, because so many shows are doing it. In fact, there's one we're going to be talking about in a few minutes that is, in fact, a revival. I don't know why they're not just doing it for this show. But regardless, it is coming back. If you guys are interested, I know there was, I guess, an audience for it because it got a second season, but whatever. 9:30, however, is probably one of the shows I'm most looking forward to, and that is a show called Me, Myself, and I.
That wouldn't be the worst day of my life. Not by a long shot.
Dad, where's my lunch?
Oh, boy. Leaving my daughter's lunch on the kitchen table isn't the bad thing I was talking about.
Sarah!
This is.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Well, at least when life hits rock bottom, things can't get any worse, right?
Wrong. When you're ranking life-changing days, it's hard to top the one where you almost die. But our life stories aren't defined by the things that happen to us.
They're defined by how we choose to deal with them.
I'll admit I have dealt with some things better than others.
So, Me, Myself, and I. This show, I really did not know too much about it. And again, CBS, not really something that usually is a good sign. I'm not usually a huge fan of CBS. Most shows I end up watching, I get taken out of. Life in Pieces was a good example. That show started off really strong, and then I think it just went way too far off the rails, and it kind of lost sight of what it was trying to do. Me, Myself, and I, however, actually does sound really interesting, because the concept of this show, I haven't really seen done before. I've seen, obviously, shows where, you know, you have someone aging, but I haven't really seen it done this way, where you see them, there's a storyline of him as a kid, then the storyline of him as an adult, then there's a storyline of him as an old man. I think it's a really cool way that they're doing that. All four of these stories sound interesting. John Larroquette is playing the 65-year-old version of him, Bobby Moynihan's playing the present-day version, and then Jack Dylan Grazer is playing him as a 14-year-old in 1991, and they all are rapidly different stories, but they're also, I think they're gonna have like a common message, so I'm looking forward to seeing how the show really does turn out. This could either be a really great show for CBS, something that's really different, or it could just be their standard comedy. I'm hoping that it actually is the first one. If it's the latter, at least it's funny. I'm hoping it's at least funny, but I think this definitely does look like a really good show. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing how this one turns out. So Me, Myself, and I, if you guys are looking forward to it, it does premiere at 9:30 on CBS, along with Kevin Kim Waits, and then Scorpion at 10 o'clock. But then we also have two other shows at 10 o'clock target, because over on ABC, we have probably one of the shows I'm looking forward to the most of these network shows, and that is The Good Doctor.
Autism. Difficulty in communicating. Difficulty in using abstract concepts. Does it sound like I'm describing a surgeon?
He saved his life.
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Sean Murphy.
Well, right off the bat, I have not seen the movie that this is based off of. I do know that it is, I believe, a Spanish film, I want to say. I know it's a foreign film. I want to say it's a Spanish film that was very popular when it came out. I've not seen the movie, but this show does look really interesting. And I will say, though, if Freddie Highmore was not in this show, I don't think I'd be as excited as I was for it. Because the fact that Freddie Highmore's on board here, I'm definitely into. Because honestly, I think Bates Motel really did help him grow as an actor. I never disliked Freddie Highmore, but I don't think he was as good as an actor as he was before he did Bates Motel. Sure, he was okay in like Arthur and the Invisibles and things like that, but he wasn't really doing as much. People didn't really know. People just kind of saw him as the kid from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, which is never a good thing. You guys know how much I despise that movie. But Freddie Highmore here looks like he's playing a very different role. You know, he's an autistic doctor, but he's also very good at what he does. He's also a surgeon. I just think it looks like a really good show. Not a huge fan of doctor shows, but I'm hoping that this actually does tell a really compelling story and isn't just like your typical procedural, because if it is, I'm out. I don't like these kind of shows. You guys know I am not a fan of medical dramas. It's just, I get it that the person's dying. I get it that the person needs medical urgency, but just it's not for me, okay? I'm not into those kind of shows. The Nick, absolutely. I will watch things like that because it's character-driven, but if it's just, you know, so-and-so is bleeding out, or so-and-so was in a car accident, or so-and-so needs medical treatment, then I'm out. I'm not gonna watch it if that's what the show is. If it's not that, then I will, in fact, watch it, but if it turns out just be your typical procedural, I might not watch it. So The Good Doctor, I am kind of torn with. I love Freddie Highmore. I'm really looking forward to seeing what he does. But on the other hand, I'm not usually a fan of these type of shows, so we'll have to see how the show really is done. But The Good Doctor, I am at least interested. Unlike the next show I'm going to talk about on NBC, which I literally have no interest in whatsoever, and that is a show called The Brave.
Deputy Director Campbell.
Hi, Adam.
Good to see you. How you been?
Better. I need your team. Wheels up within the hour.
Last week, we killed their leader, Baran Baghdadi. Well, his kidnapping isn't retaliation for something we did.
This is the personnel recovery of Dr. Kimberly Wells.
She will be executed in the next 72 hours.
There's no cavalry.
We are the cavalry.
Keep your head on a swivel. Anyone can be a hostile.
Can you bring up the body cams?
These are the final 45 minutes of pings from Kimberly Wells' cell phone.
We should be able to get an idea where they took her.
Get off me!
Anybody want to explain to me why they just drove their only hostage into a hospital?
Look, I've said this 1,000 times. I'm just sick of these shows. I really am. I'm tired of these Homeland 24 kind of shows. They're just, not that it doesn't appeal to me, I just feel like they're really excessive, and that's what this looks like to me. This looks like a lesser version of Homeland and 24, and it just doesn't really look all that great. I'm not interested in the show whatsoever. It just looks kind of boring, honestly. I like Anne Heche, I like Mike Vogel, but This show has just not grabbed me whatsoever. I have no interest in this, and I don't know if this is really going to last. It's going up against some really big juggernauts. I mean, I think, Scorpion's very popular. Good Doctor, I think, is going to do really well. The Brave, I just really don't have much interest in, unfortunately. If you guys are interested, fine, but I just don't really care that much about it. So, it is following The Voice, which obviously is very popular, so it does have a good lead-in, but just in general, I'm not really looking forward to this. But The Brave, if you guys are interested, it does come out at 10 o'clock. It's from the same producers of Homeland, so that should kind of tell you what this is about. Homeland has just gone on for so long that I just don't really care about the show anymore. That's why I stopped watching. I just don't really care, honestly. But if you guys are interested, it does come out September 25th, and that's all the stuff coming out September 25th. I'm not going to go over everything because there's way too much coming out that day. Now we get into Tuesday, September 26th, which is obviously just as crazy. I mean, there's so much coming out this day. First of all, we have the second season of Lethal Weapon, which I actually heard was great. I didn't think that show would last at all, but I've actually heard really good things about it, so check that one out, definitely. Also, we have The Mick right after that. Couldn't get into that show. Tried to watch it, just could not get into that one. But that is at 9 o'clock, and then Brooklyn Nine-Nine-Nine at 9:30. I know, 9-9, not 9-9-9. Brooklyn Nine-Nine at 9:30 if you guys are interested in that one. Over on CBS, we got NCIS and NCIS New Orleans, as well as Bull. I don't know how Bull was renewed. Everyone hated it. It got literally destroyed by all these critics, so I don't know if it had this rapid turnaround in the second half of the season. Why is Bull coming back? Because CBS doesn't want to cancel anything. That's really what it is. CBS does not want to cancel anything. They keep anything they possibly can, and so Bull... It's Bull that it got renewed. It basically sums up the show. It's Bull that it got renewed, and I don't understand it whatsoever. Over on NBC, though, it's a huge night because you do have The Voice at 8 o'clock, but at 9 o'clock, we do have the second season of This Is Us, which was easily one of my favorite shows of last year's fall season. I think this is just such a well-done show. Is it a little heavy in terms of twists? Yes. Were not all the characters that great? Yeah, I wasn't a huge fan of Kevin his first. I wasn't a huge fan of, I wasn't a huge fan of Kate. I wasn't a huge fan of her either. But this season, it actually does seem like they're going to reveal how Jack died. So I'm looking forward to seeing how that really does turn out. So This Is Us. Actually, am definitely looking forward to this at 9 o'clock. I really do hope this is a fantastic second season. I really do hope they don't butcher this. At 10 o'clock, however, is a show that I never thought I'd be interested in, but I actually really am, and that is Law & Order True Crime, The Menendez Murders.
The what matters less than the why. These boys were just little children being molded. When you terrorize people, they react precisely as you would expect them to.
Look, guys, you know me. I am the last person to watch something like Law & Order. I am not a fan of courtroom dramas. I find them boring, I find them formulaic, and I just don't really like them. However, if you put the words true crime in front of your show, your show's automatically better, because I don't know what it is, but recently I've just been so into these true crime dramas. I mean, between the, Pio versus OJ, Manhunt Unabomber's going on right now. I mean, there's been so many different ones. This just looks like a really well-done show, and it looks like this isn't just going to be, a case of the week sort of thing. It's going to be an 8-episode show, and you've got a fantastic cast here. I mean, Edie Falco, Josh Charles, Heather Graham, Anthony Edwards. I mean, just a really incredible cast overall. I don't know too much about these characters, but just like People vs. OJ, I don't really want to. I don't want to know much of what they've really done. I know my parents actually have fond memories of it, but I don't really know much about it. But if you guys are looking forward to Law & Order True Crime, The Menendez Murders, I actually am really looking forward to it. I think this honestly looks like it could be one of the best iterations of Law & Order we've had in a while. Again, I'm not a fan of this show usually, but the fact that they're doing a true crime drama, I think, is definitely the right time to do it. It's very timely. Every network is really doing it right now, and I think this could really be very successful for them. It's right after This Is Us, which is like the perfect time for this. Yes, it is going up against American Horror Story. I totally understand that, which, you know, we'll see how that one turns out. I hope it's a great season. If not, I will absolutely be watching this. But I'm going to be watching this regardless. It's one of my top three, like, one of the only, like, new shows I'm, like, really excited for. So, Law & Order, True Crime, The Menendez Murders, I am actually looking forward to this at 10 o'clock. Check that one out. I think that honestly could be a really great show. That's really everything that's coming out on Tuesday, September 26th. Again, not going to go over it all. There's just a lot of stuff coming out, but tons of stuff to choose from there. And then Wednesday, September 27th, again, crazy day. A lot of stuff happening here. We're going to start off with ABC. First of all, at 8 o'clock, we have The Goldbergs. Then right after that is Speechless, another show that I just somehow fell off of. Don't really know how, but I just did. 9 o'clock, we have Modern Family. Don't know how this show is still going on, but it is. 9:30 is a show that I did not think was getting a renew, but actually did, American Housewife. And then 10 o'clock, we have the second season, Designated Survivor. Couldn't get into that show. Really fell off of it. Just, it was too long. 22 episodes. I did not think fit that show at all. And I don't think it really belonged on ABC. I think it'd be a much better show if it was on like an HBO or a Showtime. Just doesn't really work on ABC for me. Over on Fox, we have Empire, the fourth season of Empire, which again, I'm going to catch up in the third season. I promise you I will. Did not mean to lose touch on that. It's just, after I took that trip to Virginia, a lot of things got fucked up and, that actually was one of them. So Empire, I am going to check it out. And then right after that is Star. Didn't hear too many things about the show, but honestly, if you watch Empire, you kind of have to watch Star. Why? Well, because of the fact that Star is actually going to have a crossover with Empire, and you're kind of obligated to watch both of those, which I think is a cool idea that they're doing that. Again, I'm not the hugest fan of Star. I've only watched two episodes, and neither one of them really impressed me all that much, but because of acting across it with Empire, I am obligated to watch it, so I will catch up on both of those, and hopefully we'll get reviews out to you of those when they premiere. Over on NBC, we have The Blacklist at 8 o'clock. We then have, followed by Law & Order SVU at 9, which is, again, Law & Order that I do not like, and then Chicago PD at 10 o'clock. Can't get into those shows either. Not a huge fan of those. And then over at CBS, we have at 8 o'clock, we have Survivor, which, you know, I know there's a huge fan base for that. I'm more into the Big Brother of it all. Not this season, especially. This season has been utter garbage, and just, I don't know what the season has really turned into. You guys will see my coverage on that. If not tonight, then, you know, again, I don't know when this video is going to be up. It could be up tonight, could be up Friday, I'm not really sure. But then 9 o'clock, we have a new show on CBS that, again, is another one of the shows that I really don't care much about, and that is SEAL Team.
The U.S. Navy SEALs have an elite team. Tier 1.
We have an opportunity to snatch a high-level ISIL commander.
This might be our only shot.
You never tell him to sit. The only time he's supposed to sit is when he smells explosives.
Look, guys, as I said, I am not usually a fan of CBS. When they put out a good show, I acknowledge it. This is the exact opposite of what they need to be doing. I mean, just this show in general looks like it's one of those shows that's just on because, you know, oh, it's just one of those, you know, military procedurals, and sure, there's an audience for it. I'm not the audience at all. This just does not really seem like a show that's going to last at all. It has some really stiff competition. Law & Order, SVU, I mean, you know, things like, things like Star, Modern Family. I mean, I just don't really see the show doing very well at all. It looks very bland, very boring. Nothing about the trailer really hooked me in whatsoever. If you are interested, it does premiere 9 o'clock. I just really don't have any interest in it at all. Like I said, the majority of the shows coming out this fall don't really look all that great. And yeah, Brave, SEAL Team, that's like the equivalent of like most of what these shows are. But also 10 o'clock on CBS is Criminal Minds, if you're looking forward to that. That's all the stuff coming out on Wednesday, September 27th. Not going to go through all of it again because there's just way too much. And Thursday, September 28th, again, Madhouse on NBC. We have at 8 o'clock, The Return of Superstore. Then 8:30, again, I don't know why networks do this, but The Good Place premieres on a Wednesday, but it's normally going to be on a Thursday at 8:30. I don't know why they keep doing this, but they do this a lot. And then 9 o'clock, we have The Return of Will and Grace. Now, let me give you my quick 2 cents on that. Never seen a single episode of this show. Really like the cast. I saw the 5-minute teaser that they did when they first announced like this was gonna be on in the on September 28th, and I thought it was honestly really well done. I love Deborah Messing, I love Sean Hayes, you know, I think they're both very talented actors and actresses, but I don't know if I'm gonna get to the show. I really don't. I didn't watch the original show, and I don't think it makes much sense to just start watching something that I have no prior experience with. It just does not seem like a great idea. I've done it before, The X-Files, and it did not really work out at all. People told me I had no idea what the hell I was talking about, so I don't think I'm going to do this with Will and Grace. It's just really not a smart idea. No. If you guys, the one exception I will make, if you guys give me a list of episodes, and I legit mean this, do this. Make me a list of episodes from each season. Tell me which episodes I need to watch. I will do it. I will absolutely do it. But if there's an obscene amount of episodes on there, then it's just not going to get done. But if you mark at least, you know, like 5 or 6 that I need to watch for each season, I can absolutely do that because they're like 22 minutes. They're really quick and I can get that done. I just can't possibly binge like 7 seasons. I think it's like 7 or 9 seasons of a TV show, you know, until September 28th. It's just not going to happen. There's too many other things I need to watch. But if you guys want to do what I said, by all means do that. Other than that, I don't really see myself watching the show, but unless you guys do what I said. At 9:30, we have The Return of Great News. I actually do want to catch up on the show. I heard really great things about Tina Fey's actually joined the cast for like 7 episodes, so I'm hoping it turns out to be a really fun show. I've heard great things about it. And then 10 o'clock Chicago Fire, nothing I really care about there. ABC, we got all the Shonda Rhimes shows that I could care less about. 8 o'clock Grey's Anatomy, which is a 2-hour premiere, and then I believe Scandal's gonna go at 9 o'clock, which is the final season. Then 10 o'clock How to Get Away with Murder, don't care about any of those, but that's what's premiering then. And then Startup is surprisingly coming back on Crackle. I don't know how this is coming back. I watched 1 episode and that was enough for me. I mean, I was so done with that show. If you want to talk about a show that just automatically makes you dislike every character, watch the pilot of Startup. You will absolutely find yourself despising pretty much everyone on that show. And yeah, just not a fan of that show at all. If you guys are interested, whatever, but I just personally could not get into that one. Startup is coming back. That's all the stuff coming out on September 28th, if you're interested. So now we go to Friday, September 29th. Now, usually Friday is sort of like the death night for TV, where it used to be if something was on, you know, Friday night slot, that was the Friday night death slot. But there's so much TV on Fridays that you can't possibly call it that anymore. I don't know how there is such an obscene amount of shows on Friday, but there actually is. There is such a large influx of shows. I don't understand why, but that's kind of what's going on here. Over on Fox, we have Hell's Kitchen at 8, and then I am so happy that The Exorcist was in fact renewed at 9 o'clock on Fox. Such an underrated show last year. I absolutely loved the first season. So much better than I thought it was going to be, and I'm really hoping the second season continues its quality. Do not pull a Scream Queens. Look, I love season 2 of Scream Queens. A lot of people didn't, but that show's canceled. Why? Because no one watched the second season. I really hope that Fox does not do that with this show. Fox does not seem to care much about the quality of their shows. They just care about their viewership. So I'm telling you guys now, if you like The Exorcist, watch this season, please. I know you're like, why are there an Exorcist TV show? Absolutely worth it. I love The Exorcist. It doesn't seem like something that should be on Fox at all, but it's a great show, and I definitely recommend you stick with it. Also on CBS, we have MacGyver is coming back. I'm very surprised that this actually did get renewed, but I heard after I did my rants, a lot of people got angry at me because apparently it got a lot better. So if you guys are a fan of that, go ahead. It just was, again, I never said that you shouldn't watch the show. I don't recall saying that at all. If you guys got that impression, I'm sorry. I didn't, you know, mean that. But if you guys are interested, it is coming back at 8 o'clock. And then 9 o'clock, Hawaii 5-0. 10 o'clock, Blue Bloods. All shows that my parents absolutely love. Not saying they're bad, just saying, you know, that's just kind of how it is. And then over on ABC, we have probably the most controversial new show on this entire list, which is Marvel's Inhumans.
Are we supposed to follow our king and remain as silent as he is? We need to go to Earth now.
We've been hiding here too long. Let's go to our rightful home.
If we were on Earth, we would have a glorious planet to live on, thrive on!
You're talking about betraying your brother. You're talking about treason.
You're blind to his intentions. Right or wrong, he's dangerous.
Oh boy, where do I start with this one? Look, I was so into this idea. I'm like, yes, do an Inhumans TV show. This is absolutely the right thing to do. You know, the Inhumans were so interesting on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I really wanted to see a show about them. And we had, you know, such a mature season of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. It really seemed like Marvel was going this really great direction. And then this trailer drops, and it's such a step back from everything that Marvel has been doing. You know, even Iron Fist, it didn't look this dumb. Honestly, this looks worse than Iron Fist, and that's saying a lot. You guys know I was not the hugest fan of Iron Fist. Do I think it's a terrible show by any means? No. This looks terrible. It really does. I mean, this show, the costumes look like a porn parody. They really do. They don't even look, I can't even say they look like cosplay, because I've seen better cosplay than these costumes. They look like a porn parody. It looks like you were to take the porn version of Inhumans, put them in these costumes, and there you go. That's what this looks like to me. The cast here, no one really looks like they're doing anything that great. Of course, I love, you know, Ewan, whatever his name is, who played Ramsay on Game of Thrones. Obviously, I think he's gonna do a really good job, but I don't know, the show just seems like such a step back, and the fact that they're releasing it in IMAX, it's a cool idea that they're doing that, and I am probably, this is not, you know, this is not confirmed, but I'm going to try to get an early review out for you guys. It's actually why I'm doing this video now, so I can get an early review out either Saturday, Sunday, or Monday of the first two episodes. It's really not looking good, though. The only reason I've watched in IMAX, like I said, is to get that early review, and also because it's such a rarity. I think it's a cool idea, but this show does not seem like it warrants IMAX at all. It just seems like it's a regular network show, and that's really it. It looks boring. It looks like the characters are really uninteresting. And let's put it this way, guys. I mean, they did a Comic-Con panel at, you know, Inhumans did a Comic-Con panel. Barely anyone had questions. No one really seemed to care. The cast didn't even seem that enthusiastic about it. Just in general, I don't really have much enthusiasm for Inhumans. Maybe it'll be a lot better than what the trailers have shown, but from what we've seen so far, yeah, really not looking good at all. So Inhumans at 8 o'clock. It just, this really doesn't look that great. I don't understand why Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Isn't coming back. I think it would have been smarter, honestly, for them to put Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. on and then put this in on mid-season. I think it would have been a lot smarter for them to do that, but that's not what they're doing. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. come back in, like, November or whatever. I don't really understand it, but that's what they're doing, and, you know, we'll have to see the way this goes. Just really doesn't look that great at all. And then, yeah, so that's what's going on ABC. Also, we got a couple new other things to talk about. There is the season premiere of Z Nation over on Sci-Fi, if you guys are interested in that. A lot of Netflix stuff, actually, here. A lot of Netflix stuff. We have the season premiere of Real Rob. Rob Schneider, not a fan of Rob Schneider at all, but if you guys are interested, there you go. And then the Magic School Bus Rides Again. I didn't know this was coming out this year, but it actually is. It's Kate McKinnon is playing Miss Frizzle's sister. And obviously, I love the Magic School Bus. I can remember back in third grade, we'd watch like a Magic School Bus episode every single day in my science class. It's such nostalgia for me. Obviously, I'm going to be watching this. Am I going to be reviewing it? I have no idea. I don't really know how to review something like this. But I'll check it out. You know, definitely I'm interested. You know, we'll see how it really does turn out. Is it necessary? No. But, you know, we've had this 90s craze, and this kind of continues that. And then also on Netflix is a show that I actually am looking forward to, and that is a show called Big Mouth.
Knock, knock. Who's there? It's the Hormone Monster.
No. You gotta be kidding me. Nick is right there, sir.
And
I'm a good person. I wouldn't do that laying next to a friend.
Then why am I here?
Oh my God, you're always right. What the hell is wrong with me?
Nothing. You're a perfectly normal, gross little dirtbag. Now stare at that cat clock and massage your dinger.
No, Nick's grandmother gave him that clock.
She knew what she was doing.
Yeah, she did. Okay.
Oh, what a little clock tease. Her eyes are darting back and forth, thinking, meow, meow, who's got the cream?
Me, I've got the cream.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It's okay. Just picture your dad's associate, Susan.
So, once again, like I said, Netflix, in terms of animation, has really been killing it. They have a great track record when it comes to that. I mean, Castlevania, BoJack Horseman, Evis for Family. And again, this is a very adult show, but the concept in general, I think, looks really funny. If you can't tell from the trailer, which it is hard to tell because it is actually a clip, it's not a trailer. It's about, like, hormonal teenagers, and literally it's like their hormones are, like, telling them what to do, and the hormone's, like, an actual character in the show. This just looks really creative and fun. You got a lot of people behind this. Nick Kroll, John Mulaney, Jason Mantzoukas, Jordan Peele, Fred Armisen, Maya Rudolph, Jenny Slate. Just a really great cast overall. And it just looks like it's a lot of fun. I mean, yes, it is very adult, like I said, but I think it's a really fun concept. You know, puberty is such an awkward time for a kid that I think this show is really going to satirize that very well. So I'm really hoping this is something great. I'm definitely looking forward to it. Big Mouth, I definitely will be at least checking it out and hoping it is something actually really good. And I will definitely be checking that out on September 29th when all those other shows come out. And again, I've mentioned all of them. I'm not going to get into them again, but that's really everything coming out on that day. So that's really everything that's going to be coming out in September. I know that's a lot to take in, and sadly, we're far from done, guys. October is just as crowded. Usually October, there's stuff slowing down, but there's a lot actually coming out in October. So we're just getting into right now. October 1st is a crazy day. There's so much happening, especially for Fox. All the Fox comedies come back. At 7:30, you have the season premiere of Bob's Burgers, which I actually do want to watch this show. It's not a show that I need to binge. I used to watch Bob's Burgers, but somehow I just got out of it, and I've heard really great things about it. I've heard it's like one of Fox's like best animated comedies. Some people say it's even their best of the ones they have, so I honestly might, I probably will check this out. I actually do want to watch this. I'm not going to review for you guys, but I do want to watch it. 8 o'clock, we do have, of course, The Simpsons, and then 8:30, we have a new show on Fox called Ghosted.
Where did you take us?
I'm Barry. I'm your kidnapper. And unfortunately, that's all I can say about that.
That's not very fair, is it? I work for the Bureau Underground. We investigate the paranormal and anything outside the scientific realm.
Is this a hidden camera show? Where's Alex Trebek?
Wait, did Alex Trebek have a hidden camera show? How did I miss that?
I am Captain Lefray. I am not exaggerating when I say that the fate of the entire planet may rest in your... Oh, hang on. Hey, sweetie. What's up?
I'm sorry, did she just say the fate of the entire planet?
She's talking to her daughter.
Yep, she took the call. She's the rude one.
So, with the show, I will admit I am a little bit conflicted because there are a lot of things here that I do think has a lot of potential. Craig Robinson, Adam Scott, both really funny guys, both work very well together. I think they actually do seem to have good chemistry in the trailer, and the premise as a whole actually does sound pretty funny. You know, these two guys, they have to, like, defend the world from aliens. I mean, it looks pretty funny, definitely, but the spot that it's in, I think, is really a death slot, because this is the same place that Son of Zorn was last year, and we all thought it was going to be this really funny show, and in reality, it really wasn't all that great. And not only was it not all that great, but it did terrible on Fox, and Fox aired it out of order, they canceled it, and I feel like this show is going to fall into the same exact category, unfortunately, and it's... It really sucks, because I feel like the show could have some potential. And look, mind you, I will check out the first episode, because I do actually think this looks pretty good. I mean, it does have a lot of things going for it. It's from the producers of, it's from the director of Baskets in Portlandia, both really great, TV shows, and then he's also the producer of it. A lot of great actors here, but just in general, I don't know how the show's really going to be. I hope it's funny. The trailer definitely looks funny, but again, we all thought Son of Zorn was going to be funny, so I'm not too optimistic about it, but we'll have to see how this one really does turn out. I just don't really see the show lasting, unfortunately. I wish I could say that I do think the show is going to last a while, but I just don't really see that possibility happening. So while I really do want to like it, unfortunately, I just don't know if this show has enough of a fan base and if it's really going to have the ratings to really last them, you know, it's at least even a season. So then at 9 o'clock, we do have the return of Family Guy, as well as the season premiere of Last Man on Earth. That's everything going on Fox. Over on ABC, there are a few changes happening. ABC has made some drastically different changes to their Sunday scheduling. I'm not entirely sure why, but basically 8 o'clock, no longer Once Upon a Time is on. That's actually moving to Fridays. We're going to talk about that in a little bit, but Shark Tank is actually going to be on 8 o'clock. Also, at 7 o'clock is the Toy Box. Weird night to put these things on, but that's what's going to be on at 8 o'clock is Shark Tank, and before that, the Toy Box. And then 9 o'clock on ABC, it doesn't say what's actually going to be on. I don't know what's going to be on then, but at 10 o'clock is a show that I actually am kind of interested in, and that is a little show called 10 Days in the Valley.
convince ourselves that we're in control.
Rehearsal's up!
Mommy, mommy, hi. Mommy.
But that's rarely the case.
Don't close the door, Jane. Don't you dare close the...
The question is, what do you do when you're no longer shaping your own story? Tommy, you're on fire.
Studio needs rewrites. Get the new pages to us by 4?
4 a.m.?
With a little pressure, you're going to come up with something even better.
Now, the interesting thing about 10 Days in the Valley is at first glance, you think, okay, this is going to be, you know, an ABC TV series. And it is, but it actually is, in fact, a limited series. I'm assuming that they want this to be like the new American Crime because, you know, American Crime was unfortunately canceled. I enjoyed the last season, but it was actually canceled. 10 Days in the Valley, however, while this show does sound interesting, I feel like we just got it in the summer, a little show called Somewhere Between. I mean, it basically is the same kind of plot line. You know, you got this producer, she's working for like a TV show, and then, you know, her daughter ends up going missing. If I, you know, correct me if I'm wrong, but that's like the same exact plot of Somewhere Between, and I have heard absolutely nothing about that show. It just premiered, and no one's talked about it. It's just kind of been on, and that's it. Other than that, you know, it seems like basically that's like kind of the same kind of plots. Look, I really like Kira Sedgwick, I do, but I just don't really know how the show is going to be, especially since it's from, the same person who did Rookie Blue. I tried to watch that show every single year was on, and I just could not for the life of me get into it. I just found it to be so bland and boring. But 10 Days in the Valley, just in general, I don't really know how this is going to be. Again, love Kira Sedgwick. She was fantastic. She's a fantastic actress in general, but I just don't know if she's really going to be able to carry this show. We'll have to see how this really does turn out. So I really don't have too much to say about it. We'll have to see how 10 Days in the Valley comes out. But if you guys are interested in 10 Days in the Valley, like I said, that does come out on ABC along with the other things I talked about. And then before we do get into it, over on HBO, we actually do have the return of Curb Your Enthusiasm, which I'm going to say right now, I did not watch the original Curb Your Enthusiasm, not because I didn't want to, but because it was actually way too young. The show ended, I think, back, I want to say, like 2009 or something like that. It ended, like, I know it premiered in 2000, and I did watch the first episode. I actually did like what I saw of it. So I actually am going to check this out. I did hear this isn't like a show you need to watch every episode for. Again, just like Will and Grace, guys, if you guys want to give me like the best episodes to watch of the show, then I will definitely do that, because I actually do want to watch Curb Your Enthusiasm. I heard it's a really fun show, and you know, I like the sort of episodic type. You know, I'm not a fan of episodic shows, but it's not like HBO or something like that. I can definitely get a kick out of them, and I haven't wanted to watch Curb Your Enthusiasm for a while, so most likely I will be watching that one. Over on CBS, my favorite show is also returning, Keep Bugging Up with the Kardashians. You guys know how much I absolutely despise that show, but yeah, that's coming back as well if you guys care. And then finally, we're going to go to CBS, which CBS also has a new show that's actually very similar to 10 Days in the Valley, and that is Wisdom of the Crowd.
This fall,
I have created the hub where people can submit and dissect evidence.
Real-time, crowd-sourced crime solving.
And as of right now, it is active. Let's get to work.
Welcome to the Hive, Detective.
This is where we maintain the database and monitor the platform. We vet any evidence before it's posted, and we can pull it up at the stroke of a key.
I just know there's a reason why cops solve crimes. We have this thing called privacy.
We gave that up a long time ago so we can watch cat videos on our phone.
Oh, like I said, this is very similar to 10 Days of the Valley, and just like 10 Days of the Valley, I don't really know if the show is going to last. I mean, the premise is interesting. You know, he makes this, like, app to solve his daughter's murder. It does sound interesting there, but literally in the trailer, you see that he finds his daughter's killer, and right when you see that happen, I'm like, where else is this gonna go then? What's the point of going beyond this? I mean, unless that guy isn't the real killer, this is a very misleading trailer then, but I just, in general, I don't think this is going to be good at all. I mean, knowing CBS, they're probably going to keep this because they kept Bull and nobody liked it, and I think they're going to keep this as well, but just in general, I really don't have much interest in Wisdom of the Crowd. I like Jeremy Piven, but I just don't really care about the show. The fact that they showed who actually is the killer, I just think is really dumb, and it's such a CBS move for them to do that. They always show way too much in their trailers, and this is the perfect example of that. So Wisdom of the Crowd, not really any interest in this whatsoever, but if you guys are interested, you know, you can check that one out. But also, going after Wisdom of the Crowd, which Wisdom of the Crowd premieres at 8:30 for some reason, I guess 60 minutes is gonna be like, 7 till 8:30. I'm not entirely sure why, but at 9:30 we do have NCIS LA. Never really gotten into that show, but I do know there is a fan base for that. And that's really everything that's premiering on October 1st. Oh, as well as the season of Poldark, if you guys are interested in that. That's everything premiering on October 1st, if you guys are interested. Next up, we do have on October 2nd. There isn't as much coming out that day. The stuff does start to die down, luckily, a little bit. But we do have the season premiere of Lucifer. Once again, guys, I meant to watch the show. I really did. I don't know what exactly happened, but I'm going to try. I can't promise you I will, but I'm going to try to binge season 2. I know there's a lot of episodes, but I'm going to try to do it. I heard season 2 was fantastic. Like, it took the show in an even better direction, and, you know, I really like season 1. I thought it was a fun show, but I heard season 2 is even better and took the show into a much different type of place, and so I'm definitely interested in seeing how this show really does turn out. But at 9 o'clock, we have probably one of the more promising new shows, and that is The Gifted.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, look who's here.
Why didn't you tell me?
I'm so sorry.
How do you think we got out of that gym? You too.
Alright, so when the first trailer for this came out, I really wasn't that on board with this show. However, after seeing more promos and more TV spots and things like that, I have since gotten a lot more into The Gifted. I think this is honestly a really cool idea, and what I really do like about it is it's mainly your typical family show, but it is, in fact, also having to do with the X-Men. It's about a show, like, the X-Men really aren't around anymore, and then there's this typical family, you know, they're trying to live a normal life, but their kids actually do have, these powers, and I just think it sounds like a really cool show. There was a show on ABC like this called No Ordinary Family, but it just really did not work out at all. It got way too overcomplicated, and I think this show, honestly, is a very good chance of lasting. You got a really good cast here, Stephen Moyer, you know, Amy Acker, Matt Nix, just a really great cast, and Bryan Singer actually is directing the pilot, and he's the producer, and you know when Bryan Singer has his hands attached to something X-Men, that there's at least going to be, you know, he's at least passionate about it, so you can at least say that. And do we need an X-Men TV show? No. I think it is a cool idea that they're doing one, though. I honestly think The Gifted does look like a really good show, especially when you compare it to Inhumans. It actually looks really good, and especially airing after Lucifer, I actually do think this has a good chance of surviving, so I actually am into the idea of The Gifted. What I am not into, however, is what's also premiering on CBS that day, which is a little show called 9JKL.
Joshy, it's your mother.
Bro, you in there?
It's Dad.
How great is it that we live next door to each other? Hello?
Why are you ignoring me?
I know you're in there. I can hear you breathing.
9JKL, new this fall.
Oh, God, CBS, you just don't listen ever, do you? I mean, where to even begin with this damn show? First of all, the whole premise of the show makes no sense to me whatsoever because, okay, I understand that you got this guy and he's living with his parents because he doesn't have anywhere else to go, and his parents are really annoying him or whatever, but the whole thing is that if your parents are annoying, just leave. Like, you don't have to live with them. Just go somewhere else and leave. I don't understand why this is a show. It's just really dumb to me. Mark Furstein is a talented actor. I actually really did like him on Wet Hot American Summer, this past season, but just in general, this just looks really dumb. I have no interest in this whatsoever. Not a single joke really made me laugh, and I just think this looks like a really ridiculous show. So if you are looking forward to 9JKL, then okay, but just in general, I don't really care about this, and yeah, I don't really want to say too much more, but that's really everything coming out on October 2nd. But then on Tuesday, October 3rd, we do have the return of basically all the ABC comedies. You know, The Middle's returning for its final season, surprisingly. The Middle is a show that I used to watch all the time. I haven't watched it in a very, very long time since, but it is actually coming to an end. So if you guys are fans of The Middle, there you go. At 8:30, Fresh Off the Boat. 9 o'clock, Blackish. And then 9:30 is a show that I actually do think actually looks pretty good, and that is The Mayor.
No, I'm a good rap, but nobody's ever even heard of me. Just you watch. This campaign is going to change all of that.
If you want to get discovered, just do it the old-fashioned way, waiting for a nice old Jewish man to give you his business card.
Courtney Rose's entire campaign is a stunt. Voters won't fall for that. Not in America.
Here we are. Big debate.
I'm proud to have led the effort to restore the city commons, which is now
Hold up. Have you actually ever been there? I mean, there is so much trash. Bravo gave it a second season. Don't tell us about our reality, because we live our reality every day. Courtney Rose, out. Peace.
When it does come to sitcoms, out of all the networks, it seems like ABC always seems to have the best turnout. I mean, with all the sitcoms that they have, they're all, like, really different. They have such a different variety of different kinds of stuff, and The Mayor seems like it's just gonna add to that catalog. I actually really am looking forward to this show. The main dynamic between Courtney Rose, you know, this mayor, and Lea Michele's character, Valentino, who clearly is trying to take his spot, just looks very entertaining, and obviously, no, it's not just because Lea Michele's here. I mean, I'm always on the lookout for her. She's such a great actress, and it's a bummer about Scream Queens, but this just looks like a really fun show. I can't wait to see how this one really does turn out. Don't have too much to say about, but I just think it sounds like a really cool idea, and the reason for him actually becoming mayor does seem like it makes a lot of sense. You know, he wants to promote his mixtape, and he's also, you know, this hip-hop artist, and, you know, he's really struggling, so he's kind of trying to put himself out there. I think it really is a cool idea. Also, the show is being executive produced by David Diggs, you know, from Hamilton, so, of course, I'm down for that as well. Just everything about this definitely does look like one of the more promising shows of the fall, and I definitely do want to check this one out. But also at 10 o'clock is another new show that ABC has called Kevin Probably Saves the World.
Look, I know that he hasn't been in our lives lately, but he needs us. Give him a chance.
Was that a meteor?
Sure as hell looked like it. I mean, your mom would definitely not want us to go check that out.
I know.
But I mean, we're definitely gonna go check that out, right?
Wait, I don't think we should.
So, like I said, the fall season is very much, you know, a mixed bag. There's only some shows that look really great. This doesn't really look like one of them. I mean, the fact that this show was retitled automatically gets me a little bit worried. I mean, they originally called the show The Gospel of Kevin, but then they changed it more to the much more on-the-nose Kevin Probably Saves the World, and that title, yes, it does make it sound more like a comedy show, but it just doesn't really look all that interesting. Basically, you know, Jason Ritter, he is able to talk to God all of a sudden, and he has, like, this power, and we don't exactly know, you know, why he's able to do this, but it just doesn't really look anything all that great. I've seen this concept done a million times, and I've seen it done, you know, a lot better than it has here, so I really don't have too much to say about this one. I think it just looks kind of okay, but, you know, it does have a good chance because it actually is in a good spot against all these other ABC comedies, but I just don't really see it doing that well, so we'll have to see how that one really does turn out. Also coming out on October 3rd, though, is the return, this very quick return of season 2 of Queen Sugar. I'm very surprised that it's already coming back. This literally premiered, like, in June, and it ended, like, I believe in August, so it's literally gonna be only, like, 2 months. Same with Fear the Walking Dead, but, I always tell myself this is a show that I'm going to binge, and maybe I will get around to that, but again, I'm not entirely certain. We'll have to see how that really turns out, but that's really everything coming out on the 3rd. And then October 5th, we do have the return of the final season of Scandal over on ABC, which, you know, I've never really gotten into that show, but I know there's a huge fan base for it, as well as the return of Van Helsing on Sci-Fi, and then there's a new show on Sci-Fi called Ghost Wars. I don't really have too much to say about this one. Don't really know what this one is, but I'm guessing it goes with the new direction that Sci-Fi is going into, so if you're interested in that, there's Ghost Wars, and that's everything on October 5th. Then on October 6th, it's an interesting day, because, like I said, originally this was, like, the death slots, and ABC's really changed things up here. They're moving Once Upon a Time to 8 o'clock on Fridays. I don't entirely know why, but they want to make it, like, Supernatural Superhero Night, which is a very strange, title, but that's what they're doing with Once Upon a Time. Now, I haven't watched this show in 2 years, but I know they are, in fact, revamping it, and, again, I might catch up. If I don't catch up, though, I'm simply not going to watch it. This most likely is the final season, so we'll have to see the way that really does turn out. As well as a new Italian series on Netflix called Suburra, and a show on Sci-Fi called Superstition. And then on October 7th, we actually do have a documentary on HBO called Spielberg, which basically is all about Steven Spielberg. I don't really have to say too much more than that. And then Sunday, October 8th, we have the return of America's Funniest Home Videos on ABC, as well as the return of Madam Secretary, but that's now going to be on 10 o'clock on CBS, so that'll be after NCIS LA and Wisdom of the Crowd, so look forward to that. And then Monday, October 9th, this is really when all the CW shows start to come back, starting off with Supergirl at 8 o'clock, and then 9 o'clock we have a new show called Valor.
When I joined this unit, I knew I would have to work twice as hard to prove myself.
You did everything you could. You followed procedure.
Then I'm good, okay?
You grounded, Madani.
Sir, you have to let me fly this mission.
You will have to prove you're up to it.
Are we good?
All squared away.
Oh, Valor. What a different kind of show for CW right off the bat. I mean, this is definitely not something that I would consider, to be a typical CW show. But I actually am looking forward to this, mainly because of that reason. Now, I'm not a huge fan of these, military dramas, but out of the three that are premiering this fall, this is the one that I think does have the most promise. I think, in general, CW has really been knocking it out of the park lately, and I really do hope that Valor continues that. I think this could be a really great show for them. Don't really have a ton to say about it. The trailer didn't leave a huge impression on me, but as I said, I think it's a really cool idea for CW to be going in a kind of different direction here, where they're doing a more, military type drama. It's just something they really haven't tackled, and I'm definitely interested in seeing how that turns out. But like I said, that does premiere on October 9th, along with Supergirl. Now we go to Tuesday, October 10th, where we have both The Flash and premiering, which I really do hope that this is a fantastic season. You know, after how mediocre season 3 really was, I really do hope the show gets its shit together. And it really does seem like they're doing that. They said they're going in a much more fun direction, and I think that's why season 1 remains the best season, because The Flash was supposed to be the more fun, fast-paced show to Arrow's counterpart. That's really what it was supposed to be. It was juxtaposed with Arrow's more dark, brooding nature, and The Flash kind of just became Arrow with The Flash. That's really what it became, and I think when it tries to do, it does dark stuff well, but you can't have an entire season of just darkness. And the fact they're going in a more comedic direction and a more fun direction, I do think is the right place to go. So I'm really hoping this is a great season. I'm hoping it turns out well. And, I used to love the show. I have not really loved it since season 1, to be honest with you, but I really do hope that this is a great season. We'll have to see. And then Legends Tomorrow had such a great season last year, and I really do hope they maintain that quality, because I loved what we got. I mean, talk about a turnaround for Legends Tomorrow. If Legend of Tomorrow can turn itself around, I think The Flash can hopefully do just as well, but we'll have to see. And then October 11th, this is very strange. Normally Arrow would be on at 8 o'clock, but for some reason, the CW has changed things up, and they've now put Riverdale on at 8 o'clock, which I do think is a bad idea, because, Riverdale, I thought actually did really well on Thursdays at 9. I think it actually had a pretty good fan base, and moving it at 8 o'clock up against something like Empire, I just don't think is a really smart idea. But again, I could be wrong. We'll have to see how this really does turn out, if it actually does well. I heard they're going in a much darker direction for Season 2, so I'm definitely really looking forward to seeing how Riverdale turns out. Season 1 was one of the biggest surprises of the entire year, so I'm hoping that Season 2 is just as good, if not better. The only thing I'm worried about is it's 22 episodes, and for a show like this, I don't think they need it. I think they were honestly fine with 13. scene. I would have been fine if they stuck with that length. I don't know why CW gets overzealous and always wants to extend their seasons, but 22, I think it's just a little bit too much, and we'll have to see. However, the originals also went to 13, and we saw that that really did not work for them, so we'll see if that really works for Riverdale. I think it's going to be interesting to see, but then at 9 o'clock, we have another new show that CW is trying to bring back, and that is Dynasty.
That company is the thing that Dad values most in the world. He should be giving it to me.
Oh, snap. She thought she was getting the promotion, not a stepmother.
You're not going to scare this one off, Fallon.
Your father offered me the COO position.
Fight me, Crystal. Call me Mom. Oh,
something tells me you hate surprises.
That's not what I hate.
Well, just like The Good Doctor, I have not seen the original show that this is actually based on. And maybe that's why I'm a little bit more forgiving to the trailer, because it does look like the greatest thing in the world. No, but I actually do think this looks a lot of fun. And I really do like the cast here. You know, Liz Gillies, Natalie Kelly. I mean, just I think this is a good cast overall. And because of how well Riverdale really did turn out, I am a little bit hopeful for this show. However, on the other hand, I do think this does look a little bit too over the top. It could get very melodramatic and it could get really dumb. But again, because of the quality the CW has really demonstrated lately, that's really why I'm a little bit more hopeful for this show. I don't think this looks like the greatest thing in the world or anything like that, but I do think this looks like overall a fun show. So Dynasty, I'm into the idea of it, you know, coming back. Like I said, I have not watched the original show. I know my mom's actually a really big fan and told me how different it really is from this. And I did watch a couple of the, like opening credits from the original show. But I do want to go into this. I'm going to go into it fresh. Don't really know too much about it, but we'll have to see how this one really did turn out. I overall enjoyed the trailer. Like I said, it looks a little bit silly, but I think it's going to be a fun show overall. So Dynasty, I'm overall looking forward to it. But then at 10 o'clock, we have what is probably my most anticipated return out of all these shows, and that has to be the season 3 premiere of Mr. Robot. And look, guys, I know a lot of people were not a fan of season 2, which I can totally understand. It was a rapidly different show from season 1. It was much more story-driven. There were a lot more twists. It went in some really weird directions. But for me, that is why, in my opinion, it was better than season 1. Season 1, the first couple episodes, I actually wasn't all that into. I mean, it took me a while to really get into the show. I love the premiere episode. That's not the episode I'm talking about. I'm talking about the first few episodes of the show. Until they gave us that really big twist, I wasn't as into I think it was when they killed Shayla. That's really when I started getting into that show. We got that amazing, like, one-take scene. That's when I really started to get locked into it. And from there, I think the show just stayed very consistent. And season 2 was even better for me. I think adding some of the characters they did, like, say, a Joanna or what they do with Price, you know, making them main characters, I actually thought really did benefit the show. You know, Grace Gummer's character, she was fantastic. And of course, you know, the main story going on, no, Elliot wasn't in it as much as season 1, but the twist they gave us, I thought was actually really well done. In season 3, it looks like they're going in an even darker direction. I don't exactly know what's going to happen here, but White Rose is in fact a main character, which I've always loved BD-1 in this role. I'm so happy they made him main character because he is incredible. And then Bobby Cannavale's coming to the show. And you know what? Bobby Cannavale has really been struggling lately to find a truly great show that really does actually service him. You know, Vinyl obviously did not work at all. So I'm really hoping that this actually does work out for him. I'm definitely looking forward to Mr. Robot season 3. It's taken them this long for this season to finally come out, so I really do hope it is worth the wait. And like I said, for me, it is my most anticipated return out of anything coming back. It's still, in my opinion, one of the best shows on TV. And I know it's an unpopular opinion, but I personally love season 2. I think it was an incredible season. But like I said, that'll be on 10 o'clock on USA. Also coming back is season 2 of the Shannara Chronicles on Spike, which, yeah, the show is moving over to Spike. I stopped watching season 1, but I might end up binging it, because I know they're going in a different direction in season 2, and I did hear it got better as it went on. I really was not the hugest fan of this show, but, you know, again, maybe I'll check it out. We'll have to see. So if you guys are interested, like I said, that's at Spike at 10 o'clock. But that's everything coming out on Wednesday, October 11th. Then Thursday, October 12th, again, see CW is really changing things up. 8 o'clock, we now have Supernatural. And then for the first time ever, Arrow's going to be on at 9 o'clock on Thursdays, which I think is honestly a horrible idea. And I'll tell you guys why right now. You know, if this was, say, like season 3 of Arrow, okay, yeah, I could understand that. You know, you've been on for like 2 seasons now. Maybe you want to change things up. I've seen many shows do that. The Originals is probably the biggest victim of that. They started off on a Tuesday and now they're on a Friday. So that's a big example of, you know, how they change things up sometimes. But Arrow has literally been on at the same time for 5 seasons now. And the fact that they're changing this now is a real big concern. And, you know, I really think it was a dumb move by CW to do something like this. Do I think it's going to hurt Arrow as a whole? No. I think last season was so great. And I'm hoping that this season continues that quality. Because last season, yes, it was 23 episodes. It was a season that needed to be that long, though. And they actually found a way to keep these 23 episodes really interesting. Not every episode was a hit, but most of them were absolutely incredible. And of course, you know, the villain we end up having, Chase, was easily, in my opinion, the best villain we had since Slade. And the cliffhanger we were left on, I mean, that is enough for reason for me to get hyped up for this season. Out of all the CW shows that are returning, easily Arrow's the one I'm most looking forward to, mainly because of how great the last season was. But I do think it's a dumb move on CW's part to now, just after 6 seasons, now you move the show to Thursdays. It just seems like a really bad marketing ploy. I feel like a lot of people are not going to know this is on when it is. I feel like people are, you know, they're used to that Wednesday night slots, and it's just going to be really weird when we do like a crossover this season and it's on Thursday instead of Wednesday. It's just very strange. There's usually, you know, it would be, of course, because it was supposed to be Supergirl, Flash, then Arrow, and now it's like Supergirl, Flash, then we have to wait a day, then we get Arrow, and it's just weird that they did do it like that. Legends, of course, like I said, is after Flash, so I understand that, because it actually did work out very well for them, you know, in January when they moved it there. But putting Arrow on Thursdays, I just think is a dumb move. Obviously, I'm really looking forward to it, but I just don't think it's the best thing for them to do. So, Friday, October 13th, though, we have the return of the third season of Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, which, you know, you guys know how much I love this show. It's easily probably my favorite network show on right now. Like, out of all the regular, like, of the 5 networks, it's probably the show I look forward to the most. It's just such a great character study and a great study of, you know, mental illness and things like that. All the characters are so great, and I can't wait to see where this season's really gonna go. You know, season 2 was such an incredible finale, and I don't know where they're really gonna take it from here, so we'll have to see. And then 9 o'clock, they're now gonna put Jane the Virgin on 9 o'clock on Fridays, which I think is a good idea. Jane the Virgin and Crazy Ex-Girlfriend are very similar shows, so I do think it's a cool idea for them to do that. Back on, you know, Mondays, you know, in 26, like the beginning of 2016 to 2015, that's when Crazy Ex-Girlfriend was on, so I do think it's a smart idea to put these two back together. I think it does make a lot of sense them to do that. So that is what is on Fridays. But also coming out on October 13th, and I am so hyped for this, is one of my most anticipated new shows out of any of them to come out, and that is Mindhunter.
Physically and mentally, I don't think people realize you need to vent.
You know, there's a lot more like me.
Do you think so?
40 years ago, your FBI was founded hunting down John Dillinger. Now, we have extreme violence between strangers.
We travel around the country and teach FBI techniques to cops.
You guys mind if I bother you for a minute?
She was found cuffed and lashed to the bed.
What people won't do to each other. There's nothing people won't do.
How can we help?
This show, I've talked about before. As you guys know, I did do a trailer reaction for the trailer you actually just saw. And if you guys don't know, I am so hyped for this show. For me, this is tied with The Deuce as my most anticipated new show of the fall season. Just in general, you guys know how much I love these kind of like crime dramas and things like that. And especially if you put the words David Fincher next to it. I mean, sure, House of Cards, yes, he was a part of that. I never really got into that show. I understand the appeal. It's just not really something that I really liked all that much. I tried 5 episodes, and if I'm not hooked in by 5 episodes, I mean, I don't think I'll ever be, but Mindhunter, on the other hand, looks extremely engrossing. I mean, Jonathan Groff and Holt McCallany look fantastic together, and the whole concept here of, you know, this is kind of how the term serial killer came to play, and then getting into, like, the psychology of a serial killer, just all that stuff is definitely very interesting, and I can't wait to see how that really does translate on screen. I think it's going to be a very well done show. I think this is absolutely the kind of show that Netflix needs right now. You know, I talk about all the time that Netflix is making too many shows. Netflix is doing too many shows. This is definitely, I think, something that's closer to what's in the wheelhouse, and I think they should definitely focus on something like this. I really do hope this turns out to be a really great show, because given the promotion and everything we've seen so far, I'm really loving it, and I would hate for the show to disappoint me. So I'm absolutely hyped for Mindhunter, but that's, like I said, everything really coming out on October 13th. Now we get into October 14th, which on Saturday we have the premiere of the second season of Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency. This was another show I was going to watch, but I just never really found time to watch it. But maybe if I have time, I will binge it in time for the second season. I actually heard really good things about it, so do want to check it out. And then on October 15th, we do have a couple things. We have the season premiere of Good Behavior over on TNT, as well as the premiere of Berlin Station on Epix. And then we have a new show on Showtime called White Famous.
I do comedy, sir. I make room full of people laugh.
I'm Floyd Mooney. Thank you so much.
Yeah, small rooms and small, depressing clubs east of the 10, south of Crenshaw.
You obviously need a career boost.
I happen to be producing a movie with Jamie Foxx. You ought to meet with this director.
I'm making this movie about an African-American attorney.
That's cool. You can say black.
Oh, no, I never say black.
Oh, good, man. Good for you. That was a test, obviously.
You play the old woman.
Wait, what?
So again, this show, I've talked about it before. I definitely really looking forward to this. You know, Jay Farrow on SNL. I haven't really watched a lot of SNL, but when I've seen his skits, he definitely is very funny. And what I really do love about the show is it really does seem like it's focusing on what an actor really goes through. I mean, you know, not only is he having to play someone that's so against type, but he has to play someone that's not even his gender. And it basically just shows that sometimes in Hollywood, you just have to kind of take the roles that you can get. And I think it just sounds like a really fun show. Stephen Tobolowsky's in here, Michael Rapaport, just a really great cast overall. And then Jamie Foxx as well. You know, this is based on the early career of Jamie Foxx, actually, which I think is really interesting. So I'm definitely looking forward to the show. I think this looks like a lot of fun. So White Famous, definitely looking forward to this one. But next one we have to talk about is on Tuesday, October 17th, when there's another new show coming out, actually on Audience Network, and that is a show called Louder Milk.
Look, man, I gotta tell you, as your sponsor and your only friend, you really make it hard for people to like
you. What are you talking about? I'm a people person.
You called my daughter a slob.
You gotta admit, the girl smells a little bit like a rotting corpse.
This guy body checked me on the stand.
He's a little exaggerated.
Don't drink. Don't drink.
Actually, I am a recovering meth addict.
Still good advice. Take a shower.
So, not really a ton to say about this one, mainly because I'm judging the show based off a 30-second teaser, and I can't really say too much about it. I haven't watched many of these Audience Network shows. I know Mr. Mercedes is really popular right now. I actually do want to try to watch that one before the miniseries ends, but Louder Milk, on the other hand, I don't know, maybe I'll check this out. Again, I don't have DirecTV, so it's not like this is accessible to me. You know, I can always try to watching in some way. I have my ways, obviously, but I don't know about this one. We'll see how this one really does turn out. So again, not too much to say, but it does premiere on October 17th if you guys are interested in that. Then on October 18th, over on Hulu, we have the second season of Freakish, which I actually was interested in. I was going to watch the first season of last year. I don't know why I didn't, but the concept of this just is really interesting, and yeah, so I might actually binge that one. We'll have to see. And then October 21st, this is really interesting. There's a documentary on Hulu called Too Funny to Fail. It's basically a documentary all about the Dana Carvey show, if you guys are interested in that. I never really watched it, but I know it was a popular show, so, you know, check that one out. And then October 22nd, this is obviously a big day. We have, first of all, the season premiere of Graves, but that's not the big one. The big one, obviously, is the season premiere of The Walking Dead, which I know a lot of people are very iffy about, because last season wasn't the best. I will fully admit that last season is not the best the show has done. But I did think it was good build-up, and I did think they did a really good job in building up how the show is really ultimately going to be. I think we're just going to have to see how the show really does, in fact, turn out. But I'm looking forward to it. You know, the trailer itself, the Comic-Con one, wasn't all that great. It didn't really hook me in. I thought it was just, you know, kind of just, it was, you know, very lazily put together trailer. But maybe the season's going to be good. We'll have to see. I'm definitely looking forward to it overall. So Walking Dead does come out then. Then Tuesday, October 24th, we have two shows that I don't really have much to say about. First of all, we have At Home with Amy Sedaris on True TV. Then we have a new show on TBS called The Last OG. Don't know if this is a trailer out there for that one yet, so not going to say too much about this one. But then on Thursday, October 26th, a reality show on TBS called Drop the Mic, which is like a rap battle series based on a segment from James Corden's show, which, I love James Corden's Late Late Show. So if you guys are into that, there's that as well. And then the only other dates to talk about, the last one we're talking about here, is on October 27th. We do have the return of Blindspot, but of course, the big one is the return of Season 2 of Stranger Things. And guys, I am obviously hyped for this premiere. I think, really, you know, besides Mr. Robot, this is the one I'm looking forward to the most. I love Season 1, obviously. I did not know if the show needed a Season 2, but from what I saw in the trailer, it looks like they're really stepping it up, and they're really going to deepen the mythology, and also give us a lot more with the characters as well, you know, more 80s references. I think in general, this is just going to be bigger and better than the first season, and the fact that they already have, a plan for the end, I think is definitely a good idea. I've said this before, I like shows that have an end in sight, shows that don't have an end in sight, like, you know, Cough the Walking Dead. They just seem to go off the rails a lot, but things like Stranger Things that actually does have an end in sight, where they actually know, okay, here's how we're going to start and here's how we're going to end it, that's something that I definitely am looking forward to. So Stranger Things, absolutely, I think so many people are looking forward to this, and I can't wait to see how Season 2 really does turn out. It's been a very long wait, just like BoJack Horseman and just like Mr. Robot, but I think definitely it will absolutely pay off here. And with that, guys, we have now made it to the end. I know this was a very hard video to sit through, and I very much do apologize for that. But hey, I wanted to get as many premieres out I can as possible. With that said, though, guys, I am actually going to take you guys through all the shows I'm going to be watching and reviewing, you know, for the fall. I'm going to give you my schedule right now. I know I always do that, so I'm just going to give it to you guys right now. Now, some of these shows I did not talk about. Like I said, things are coming out in November and December. I simply did not talk about because I, you know, most times in November, there's other things that get announced, and I didn't want to miss something. So right now, this is what my schedule looks like. And of course, this is for September and October. That's probably going to change November. But for Sunday, first off, I will be reviewing every episode of Star Trek Discovery. If it's good, that is, I definitely will be reviewing every episode. I will be reviewing the season of Bob's Burgers. Outlander, I will review every episode at 8 o'clock. Then 9 o'clock, we have Fear the Walking Dead and The Deuce, which I will be reviewing every episode of both of those shows. I will watch Curb Your Enthusiasm, but I'm not planning on reviewing it. I will definitely be watching it, though, so stay up to date with me on that on Twitter. And if it really is all that great, it might even make it in my top 10. We'll have to see. I will probably binge the first season of Vice Principals, which then I will allow me to review the season. And then White Famous, definitely do want to check that one out, and I will be reviewing the season of that. Then on Monday at 8 o'clock, I will definitely be watching Supergirl and obviously reviewing every episode. If I can binge Lucifer, I will watch it, and not only that, but I will review every episode, you guys, because I definitely have wanted to review that show for a while. And then The Gifted, I will definitely be reviewing every episode of that. Valor, I will review, but when the season's over, because there are just so many shows, and, you know, I can't review everything, so I will review the season of that. Me, Myself, and I, if I really do end up liking it, I will review the season of that. And then The Good Doctor, you know, if it really is as good as I think it's going to be, I will review every episode. And then on Tuesdays, The Flash, obviously every episode, then right after that, Legends Tomorrow. This Is Us, I will continue to review the season. I think it's just, you know, that's a show I'd rather review the season of when it's over. The Mayor, I will review the season of. American Horror Story, Cole, obviously every episode. Law and Order, True Crime, The Menendez Murders, every episode. And then Kevin Probably Saves the World. If I do end up watching that, which I am going to check out the first episode, I will review the season. Then on Wednesday, Riverdale, I will review every episode of that. Empire as well, every episode. Dynasty, if that's, you know, really great show, I will review every episode. Star, as well every episode, and then Mr. Robot every episode. Wednesday's kind of a crazy day. There's a lot on, but Then You're the Worst, just like the first three seasons, I will just review the season of that show. And then I am going to watch South Park, but I'm not going to review it. And then Broad City as well, I'm going to watch that, but I'm not going to review it. I will watch it, though. And then Thursday, Young Sheldon, I'm going to review the season when that's over. The Good Place as well, I'm going to binge season one, and then I will definitely review the season two, guys, when season two is over. Arrow, obviously, every episode. Done it for, like, you know, five seasons now. The Orville as well, every episode, as long as it's, you know, a great show. If it's not something, again, if these shows aren't great, I'm simply not going to be reviewing them, and I'll give you guys a heads up if that's the case. But great news, I'm most likely going to binge the first season, and then I will review the second when it ends. And then Better Things, I will be watching, but I don't plan on reviewing that show. But, you know, like I said, definitely will be watching it. But definitely check out that show if you haven't, guys. It is incredible. Friday, Once Upon a Time, if I do catch up on it, I will review every episode of that, but I don't anticipate that's going to happen just because it's two seasons and it's kind of crazy. It's, you know, it's a lot to do, 22 episode seasons. It's kind of crazy. But then Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, obviously I will be reviewing the season of that. Inhumans, very, very iffy on this one. I'm going to probably see it in theaters this weekend, and if I like what I see, I'll review every episode. If not, I'll just review the first two episodes and be like, this is why you shouldn't watch it, or I'll review the season. We'll see what I really end up doing with that. But The Exorcist, I will continue to review every episode, so just like I did last year. And then Jane the Virgin, I know I have to catch up on season three, but I will do that, and then I will review season four. Saturday, I am planning on reviewing every episode of Halt and Catch Fire. Just need to review the first three for you guys. And then when DuckTales ends, I will review the season of that, because DuckTales actually is going to be coming back. And then finally, Oliver on Netflix, I will also be reviewing every episode of Mindhunter and Stranger Things, as well as the season of American Vandal, BoJack Horseman, Freakish, Fuller House, Narcos, One Mississippi, and The Tick. And with that, guys, that's it. That is everything that I will be watching in the fall. Please comment down below. Let me know what you guys think is, you know, the best shows coming out this fall. What are your plans? Things like that. All the shows you guys are definitely looking forward to. But that's for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, sorry of the length, but I just wanted to keep this video as thorough as possible. And I will see you guys in my next video, which will definitely be for this week of Big Brother. I know you guys have been waiting for that, and I will see you guys for that. Okay, bye.